Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about basic electrical engineering subject module number 2. In this you have single phase AC circuits. So first we will discuss about introduction and next pure inductive circuit. Coming to the introduction. So what is the difference between AC circuit and DC circuit? In AC circuit the magnitude of the current or magnitude of the voltage will vary with respect to time. In DC circuit the magnitude of the current or the magnitude of the voltage always constant with respect to time. So in AC circuit that at every instant the magnitude will be changed, and DC circuit the magnitude will be constant at every instant. So you can see here the AC waveform is like this. So here AC waveform is alternating current or alternating voltage waveform looks like this. But in DC current the magnitude will be constant. Suppose if you take current, so it looks like this. So in x axis time, in y axis magnitude if you consider. So here in a circuit alternating circuit current always changes with respect to time. In DC circuit the magnitude will be constant with respect to time. So this is the major difference between this AC and DC. And we will move to the next inductive circuit. If you consider a pure inductive circuit, it is connected to alternating voltage V. So due to alternating voltage, alternate current will flow as shown in the figure. So as shown in figure, so if you take inductor L is connected to alternating voltage V, and so due to alternating voltage current will flows in this through the inductor. Okay, so here the pure inductor does not consume any energy, it will store in the form of electromagnetic field. Okay, so here we need to prove how the current and voltage will varies in pure inductive circuit and how the power will be there, right? So let the applied alternating voltage V is equal to Vm sin omega t, V is equal to L into di by dt. So in inductor, so current flows, magnetic flux will produce, magnetic flux due to the magnetic flux emf will produce. That emf here, emf will produce, emf is opposed the supply voltage, applies the supply according to Lenz law, right? So now according to that, if you take V is equal to L into di by dt, so if you want to get in current, so what we have to do, so we need to integrate both the sides. So both the sides you integrate, integration if you take, so finally you will get I is equal to Im into sin of omega t minus pi by 2. So here in inductive circuit V is equal to Vm sin omega t, but current I is equal to Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2. So now if you take these two current and voltage equations, we compare, we can say that current lags the voltage by an angle pi by 2. If you take voltage is a referent voltage, if you take current leads the voltage by an angle pi by 2. So like this. So these are the according to waveforms. Now instantaneous power P. So generally P is equal to, in DC circuit P is equal to V I. So substitute V and I, so both equations in this instantaneous power P is equal to V I. So Vm sin pi, Im sin of sin pi minus pi by 2. So substitute and simplify, will get power value will be equal to 0. So power value will be equal to 0. So you can say that the pure inductor or pure inductive circuit does not consume any energy. So in any power or energy or any power, it will store in the form of electromagnetic field. So that's what. So that's what. So this is the inductive circuit. So pure inductor does not consume any electrical power, it will store in the form of electromagnetic field. So now what we have to do, so we have to draw the voltage current waveforms. Voltage is like this. The current is lags the voltage. So current lags the voltage will be like this. So in this period, if you take power will be negative here. So here one more time I will draw this circuit. One minute here. So take voltage waveform. So current waveform lags the voltage. So in this period power will be negative, in this period power will be positive. Like this we have to draw waveforms for power voltage current to T, right? So this is about waveforms of pure inductive circuit. Okay, so what you have to write in this pure inductive circuit, generally they may ask two different types of questions. One is direct question like explain pure inductive circuit and also draw the waveforms of current, voltage, power waveforms. So in another type of question is indirect question. So show that pure inductor does not consume any power. It will pure inductor does not consume any power, and also draw the waveforms of voltage, current, power waveforms. Okay. So what you have to do? So you have to draw the inductive circuit diagram. This circuit diagram you have to draw, and voltage we have to voltage equation you have to consider. So current equation you have to get by integrating the voltage equation. So by that you have, what you have to do, current lags the voltage, current in inductor, current lags the voltage, so voltage by an angle 90 degrees. Then power, so since is one slide, I cannot show all the derivations. I have skipped some of the steps here. So if you substitute voltage current in this equation, so from the inductive circuit, Vi sin pi into Im sin pi minus pi by 2. So here we will get this one, and the pure inductor does not consume any real power. Any power it will store in the form of electromagnetic field. So these things we have to show, and also you have to draw the waveforms. Waveforms you have to draw. So waveforms you have to draw, and you have to show that active average power in pure inductor circuit is also will be equal to 0. That thing also you have to show. Okay, and next video, so we will see other topic, pure capacitive circuit. Okay, so pure capacitive circuit also is similar to the pure inductive circuit, but voltage current equations will be different, and power equation will be different. So power equation also will be same as a inductive circuit, but so we have to derive the power equation in terms of different current and voltage equations, and we'll see in the next video about pure inductive circuit. Okay, thank you everyone.